a complex signal. Okay, so what do you mean by that? Now this 1 plus 1j can also be described as 1 square plus 1 square and then the angle of 45. Right? Now, if you have problem with this, plus look up complex number. Okay. Complex number. Essentially what we're saying is this. First, the sine wave plus sine wave, sinusoidal wave, can be described as a phasor. Next, we say that phasor can be represented as a complex number. Okay, now you have this complex number, what does it mean? Complex number plus is such that real is real, imaginary is imaginary. When you want to do addition, for example, I have, in the real signal, if I have 2 plus 3, what do you get? 5. Okay. Now, supposedly, the complex number, I have 2 here, and then 3 here. When you have 2 plus 3j, is it equal to 5?
No.
Is that clear? It is not equal to 5. Instead, you have 2 here, plus 3 here, and then this becomes your 2 plus 3j. Second, that is the result. Unfortunately, we don't have so much time. So anyone of you have this problem, please look up complex number, multiplication. And addition. Yeah. Alright, what about this? We carry on now. So, for example, if I have a complex signal where length is here, 6, this one here, so 6 plus 8 is not equal to 14. Instead, it is 6 squared plus 8 squared, then 14 squared root becomes 10. Second, right? So that is basically vector addition. So in this case here, plus, supposedly I have a waveform signal which is 6 volts, 0 degree, and this one is 8 volts, 90 degree. What does it mean? Remember, 6 volts, 0 degree is something like this, like 6 volts, 6 here, right? 8 volts, 90 degree will be 8 volts, 90 degree. Second, so when you add them together, what do you get? 10 volts. Okay. It's equal to 10 volts, and what's your angle here? If you work it out, it will be 53.13. Second, so let's just do some simple complex number additions. A plus JB plus C plus JD, what do you get? Will be equal to A plus C plus J B plus D. Second, and if it's minus, then it will be minus here. It will be minus here. Second, now, the other thing about complex number, example, we also have this plus a squared, a plus ab, which is, it is equal to a squared plus b squared square root, that is a negative, and then this one is arctangent of e over a. Alright? You can express a complex number. In other words, a plus jb is equal to magnitude and theta, right? M is equal to a squared plus b squared and theta is equal to arctangent e over a. Okay? Now, plus, for the case of complex number, let's say, alright, so move on. So, complex number, you can actually express them in rectangular form where you have real and imaginary, or you could actually express them in magnitude and the angle. Is that correct? The polar form. Which is why I say that this side is polar, this is polar form. Polar form. This one is rectangular. Okay. Alright. So this side polar, this is rectangular. You can express them. Okay. If you don't know how to express them, try to use your calculator. But it's always good to look up Max book to do that once. Sine wave, another sine wave, when I add them together, it becomes something like this. Okay? So, a periodic signal is actually consists of many sinusoidal waves. Is that correct? Now, when you look at the time domain, this is what you have. Okay? So, if you want to look at the frequency domain, what do? You look at the frequency domain, in max, we do Fourier series analysis or Fourier transform. Okay? But in electronics, what do? Well, in electronics, this is what you can do. You could use a spectrum analyzer. Okay? And when you have a spectrum analyzer, for example, this is a time domain signal, what do you get? A time domain signal, you go to the spectrum analyzer, it tells you the peak. So for example, you have a peak here, this gives you one frequency. Another peak here gives you another frequency. So this particular signal, it is a summation of a few frequencies with a different amplitude. Second, right? So if you look at a square wave, what does it mean? Square wave is essentially, if you look back, it is an addition of different sine wave. Second, so as a result, this one here is essentially, if you look in the frequency domain, peak at different frequency. You add them together. Second, right? So, these few slides, as we say, is a signal, AC signal, can be converted into frequency domain. And to convert it to frequency domain, you make use of the spectrum analyzer. Second, and each of these spectrum essentially is what you have learned in mathematics, the Fourier coefficient. Right? That gives you the strength of that frequency component at that particular frequency. Yeah? Are you okay? Not okay. That is also not okay. So how? Now essentially we are saying this. If I were to have this signal plus this, when the two signals act together, you are going to see something like this. Right? You get this? Get this now? Okay. So, what does it mean? If I have a time domain signal, can you tell me? Can you tell what frequency you have? Well, basically the frequency is frequency component you have is basically one frequency, the F1, this is probably F2. Second. Okay, now another square wave is actually consists of this plus this plus this plus this. Okay. So what we are saying is this, in the time domain, when I observe some signal, we will be very much interested to know what is the frequency content, right? Okay, so to examine the frequency content, essentially, this is what you do. You do the Fourier transform, signal or Fourier analysis, to get your frequency to observe frequency content. Okay? So that is when you do a Fourier analysis. But in electronics, you do the spectrum analyzer. That's all. Second. Okay. Right. Next, we look at the behavior of component. Now, this is what we have. Resistor. You know that P is equal to I R. Okay. Now, look at this here, class. Your R is a real number. Okay. Okay. So, for example, let's say my example, if my R equal to 2, then what do you have? Your V is equal to 2i. Okay? Then the V equal to 2i. Agreed? So what does it mean? If I have, look at this one here, V equal to 2i. Let's say, for example, if this is my I, what's my V? V is equal to 2i. It means V will be just like that, right? Agreed? Am I right? Let's say this is I, this will be 2i. They will be in phase. Agreed? Am I right? Okay. So that being the case, this is what you see. Your E and I, typically they will be in phase. Alright? Because this one is the real number. Okay? Now, power is E times I, right? So E times I will give you something like that. Okay? So if this is a I, this is E, when you multiply, big times big will give you big. Small times small will make it smaller. So you will end up having something like this. Okay? Now, mathematically, it can be proven, but in the interest of time, just forget about it. What is more difficult for the inductor? Now, inductor plus, it is your voltage is given by this. E is equal to dL dt, dI dt times your L. Okay? Now, if you remember the control, right, last sem. This sem. Last sem, what you learn? No control. Okay, Laplace, you still remember? Okay. When you do this, this is this is x of t, dx, dt. Right, let's say x go to x of s. If Laplace of this will give you s d, so x of, right, minus something, your initial condition. Assuming you don't have an initial condition, then what do you get? You have s of this, right? Now, this s operator can be represented as j omega, okay, which is equal to j 2 pi m. Second, okay. Now, in our analysis here, we are looking into Fourier. Okay, so Fourier, your E inductors are plus inductors have this behavior. When your flux change, okay, when your flux change, it induces a voltage. Okay, when your current change, it induces a voltage. So you change your current very fast, your voltage induces very fast. Very big, sorry. Okay? So if that's the case, your voltage, right, plus your voltage, it is proportional to the rate of change. Okay? So supposedly this is my current. Okay? Now can you see the slope here is big? Big slope, right? So big slope, your E will be big. Second, as come to here, what's your slope? Slope is slope equal to zero, right? So E will be equal to zero. Got it? So the red one give you the current, the E will be a shift. Second, and who come up first? Your E come up first. Alright? So inductor, voltage lead current. Okay? Voltage increase faster than the current. See? Your current slowly, right? Voltage go up already. Okay, so inductor voltage leads current. Okay. Right. So because of this 2 pi f here. So there's this term here, we call it impedance. Impedance is equal to 2 pi f L. 2 pi f and then multiplied by your L. Second, okay, all these things are for the time being just remember it. Otherwise you have no time. Okay. Now plus look here. What it means is this, your impedance is changing with frequency. Agree? Right. Impedance change with frequency. It changes with frequency. Frequency increase, what will happen? F increase. The XL